Praise the Lord. Good to be in God's house tonight. Amen. I do thank the Lord, amen, for this beautiful day that He's made. Amen. I'd like to ask you to remember the Turner family. Sister Sharon passed away this evening. Amen. For this afternoon. Amen. Sister Tanya said they deserve our prayers. Amen. So remember her in prayer. Remember that family. Amen. Sister Tanya really needs our prayers. Brother Pee Wee just buried his mother-in-law. Amen. And now his mother. Amen. So pray for that family. Also still remember the Blankenship family. Amen. Also remember Brother Danny Patrick. Brother Keith said he's doing better. He's walking a little bit. And they don't want to push him too much, but just continue praying for him that God will continue blessing. Amen. Touching him. I told him he's got to get back out there preaching again. Amen. Many people, he is rich. I watch him when he would go and he would witness the people in the restaurant and walk up to him and say, hey, you know Jesus. Amen. So, Brother Danny is a good one. Amen. So remember him in prayer. Also remember Brother Timmy Brown tonight in your prayers. And Sister Tammy. Sister Tammy is really battling, amen, with this breathing. Amen. She's having a hard time. Amen. So she does need our prayers. Also, Brother Timmy needs our prayers too. That's his sister. Amen. Sharon that passed. Amen. Remember all Sharon's sisters also. Amen. Remember Sissy tonight. What's the other one's name?
Sandra.
Amen. Remember them tonight that God will keep his hand on them. Daniel and Eric also. Amen. Remember all the foster kids that they've got. It's going to be hard on them. Amen. So remember that. Remember Brother Bob Sandlin up in Ohio. His sister-in-law. Amen. She's had heard how she was doing. Amen. But she's been battling the old C word. Amen. So remember that. Remember Brother Darrell and Sister Frances and Little Artie. Amen. Sister Judy McCarty and Sister Margie Burkett. And Sister Carly Pope and her family in prayers. I was telling Nora before we come to church, I pulled up the news on WKO. And an 11-year-old boy went on a camp thing, a youth camp thing, and, at a water park, but he died at 11 years old. A medical emergency came up, and he died. And but it wasn't to do with the water, or he was in water or nothing. So remember that family in your prayers. Said they desire people's prayers for the family. Amen. So remember that family. Amen. I told people, I said, you know, death is sure. And it don't matter what age you are. It's time for you to go. You're going to go. Amen. So remember that family in prayer. Anybody else got a prayer request?
Remember Carrie and Jeff. Carrie, she was really heartbroken when I gave her the news about Sharon. She's known Sharon for a long time. And really, you know, tore up. Remember them. Remember Josh passing. Remember all my lost loved ones. Remember all the local churches around. Continue to remember me. I'm supposed to go to Louisville, Tennessee. I'm not for a yearly checkup. I'm not sure I'm going to get to go again or not. But remember all my lost loved ones in prayer.
Yes, amen. Somebody else.
Remember me and my family
and
my lost loved ones.
Yes, amen. Somebody else.
Well, I got a praise report. I know it's prayer request time, but I want to give us a praise report.
Well, I was just waiting.
The CT scan in April, of course, y'all knew what they said about it. And so, anyway, yesterday I got my results back, and it had decreased down to a pea size, and it was benign.
Amen. Praise the Lord.
They're going to do another one in like 6 or 8 months, and I'm praying it'll be completely gone.
Amen.
Actually, the one that read this one, it's kind of odd because he had all these kind of numbers on this paper, and I was actually confused, so I messaged my doctor last night, and I said, I don't understand what all this is. You've scribbled out and put, you know, it's not this, it's not this. And she said, well, I don't understand what they did, but there was a lot of typo errors. And she said, I'm going to call them today. So she did, and then she called me. And she said, you're good. She said, there's nothing there. She said, before they was worried about it could have been. I'm not going to say the word because I never did really want to claim it no way. And but she said, it's down to a pea size. I said, so does that mean I have to do that scope? She said, no, you're good. She said, but we're going to wait 6 or 8 months and check it again. That way you're not getting so much radiation. I'm praising for it.
That's right. Amen. Yeah. Also, remember Sister Misty. She had surgery yesterday.
Yeah, she's really,
really hurt. She's really sore and stuff. She said that everything came off and was all right. Amen. So remember her in prayer that God will strengthen her body. And she'll be able to get up and be back on the move. Amen. Somebody else.
Remember Aiden, because he screams and cries from the time he gets up until he goes to bed. And I'm not going to say what he says. Everybody already knows. But it's bad. I mean, it got on my nerves so bad, I couldn't hardly stand it. And then remember Reed, because she's got to have MRI done where they found a mass on her kidneys. And I keep telling her she needs to get in church and not just not just play with God. You just can't do that, but you know, that's all I can do.
Sure. Right. Sure, amen.
Sissy and Rick's working on things. They're either going to sell their home by the end of August, or she told him he's either going to have to rent it out, sell it, or she's coming out. So that's their story.
Amen. Remember that. And I remember Sister Charlotte. She hasn't been feeling good. Pray for her. She's got a cold or something. She said that her son keeps the trailer at 50 degrees inside, and she says have to run a heater to try to stay warm.
That sounds like
he must
be
so but I don't know, you know, if it's that or not. Amen. But remember her in prayer that God will touch her, and she's always also wanting to try to find her a place to move to. So ask, remember that for her, that God would help her find a place that she can move to and get out of the trailer. Amen. All right. Remember Sister Jackie tonight. Amen. In your prayers. She's been doing a whole lot better. But continue to be with her. Remember Nora's cousins. Amen. In your prayers. Remember her baby brother, Brad. Sister Connie and his baby brother, Brad. Amen. In your prayers. Also remember his kids, his children, Kelly and Cheyenne and Matthew. Amen. And what's the other one's name? Hunter. And
William.
And the little girl's name is?
Emily.
Amen. Remember them in prayer. Yes. Pray for his children. Amen. So remember them. Also remember his mother-in-law. Amen. In your prayers also. Amen. Remember all those that's here recently, amen, that's been sick a lot. Amen. My oldest brother, continue, remember him, he has to go and have some tests run on his legs and his shoulders where somebody run over the top of his poor bed. And I showed Nora the pictures, and if it hadn't been for God, he wouldn't be here. Brother Morris, he'd been decapitated. And the firemen's and the first responders then said that he wouldn't have never made it. If it hadn't been for that, he wouldn't have made it. Amen. So remember him, though. I want to see him get back right with God.
Charlotte said, I'm doing okay now, trying to get there.
Amen.
Also,
then they're coming.
Yes, amen. Amen. Remember the service tonight.
Remember Linda Crenshaw, she's got some surgery coming up.
Yes, that's the one. Lana Crenshaw talked to Lord yesterday. He said that she's got some tests and stuff coming up, surgery. Amen. Ask for prayer. So remember her, Brother Ray. Amen. Also remember Junior and Ashley in your prayers. Amen. Also remember my family. I've got lost loved ones that I want to see saved. I got sister-in-laws that I want to see saved. I got nephews I want to see saved. I got nieces that I want to see saved. And I told my nephew up in Indiana here a while back, I told him, I said, you was raised right. Your grandma and your grandpa raised you right. You know right from wrong. Amen. So pray for him. His name's Brian. Amen. And I want to see him saved before it's too late. Remember the service tonight. Pray for each and every one that's around here tonight. Pray for your family. Pray for your lost loved one. Amen. Pray for this service. Pray for Brother Michael tonight. Brother Michael Zinman's going to be bringing the word for him tonight. Amen. So pray for him tonight.
Also, remember Daniel's mama's brother. That's the only one she has left. And it's real bad.
Yeah. Also, remember Tanya's cousin.
Chastity.
She's in Louisville Hospital and she's not really doing good neither. Amen. So remember her in prayer.
Remember Amy still. Lemma called me and said that she went to a doctor in Louisville and said that she told me that she had a CAT scan, but she really just had an ultrasound. But she said from what she looked at the ultrasound, said it doesn't look bad, but she's going to do a CT scan on it. And she still has to go to a doctor about her liver, place on the liver.
Yes, amen. Remember that. Also remember Rusty tonight. Amen. In your prayers. There's somebody else that's just praying. Anyway, unspoken request by the raising of your hands. Pray to see you. Pray to y'all.
Situation for them, Lord God. If everything will go all right and smooth, Lord God, I ask in the name of Jesus, Lord, he asked for prayer. God, we just ask God you move upon them, Lord God. Lord, I ask God that you would move upon these needs tonight, God. Sister Bonnie's requests, Lord God, and her family, Lord. Lord God, Sister Darling, Lord God, thank you for that praise before God and we got to our God. Lord, we ask God you touch Sister Misty, Lord God, strengthen her body, Lord God. In the mighty name of Jesus, Lord Daniel. Uncle, Lord God, I pray, God, that you would be with him, Lord God. Heavenly Father, Chastity, Lord God, I pray, God, whatever it is, God. Oh, God, she'll call out upon you, Lord God. Make things right, Lord God. Oh, Heavenly Father, God, be with the Turner family, Lord, be with Tommy, the kids, Lord God, and Derek, and Daniel, Lord God, and Pee-wee, and Robin Holmes, God, be with them. Father, God, not our will, but your will be done tonight. Lord, I ask God you give her, Lord, Brother Bob Sandman, Sister, all, Lord God, that you touch her. Heavenly Father, Lord, that you bless him abundantly, use him tonight in a mighty way. Heavenly Father, God, Lord, I just ask God to open up the windows of heaven, pour out your spirit upon us, Lord. Bless the singers tonight. Lord, bless those that you will sing some Christmas, Lord God, we ask. Heavenly Father, God, in your son's name, God, I give you praise for it.
Jesus. Some to come, and if they come, amen, it'd be all right.
Amen. Because they can worship the same way we can worship. Amen. In my dream, they said, we worship Jesus, which is Jesus. Amen. I said, well, we can worship that. Amen. That's who I worship. Amen. I worship Jesus. Amen. And he said, see, you learned that word already, Jesus. I said, well, I already know that one too. But amen. But you know how God will show you things. Well, I was reading the Bible today, and I was studying the Word of God today, and God began to show me something over there in Joshua. I mean, Judges. Amen. And I was reading about Samson and how that they done what Samson had done and how he killed the Philistines and all that. Amen. But I thought about when he killed all of them, more than he'd ever killed before. Brother Morris, they were in there worshiping Dagon. Dagon, which is the mermaid god. How many of y'all saw down in Florida, down there when they was having the gay pride thing, they were dressed up like mermaids. They were all dressed up like mermaids. They were wearing mermaid clothes, and they were wearing this, and as I was reading that, God showed me something. That's what they're worshiping. They're worshiping that Dagon god. When they put the Ark of the Covenant in there, what happened? Amen. The Ark of the Covenant would turn the Dagon god over. Sister Teresa? Amen. And God was showing me today, I'm fixing to turn it over. I'm fixing to show Dagon that I am still God. I'm the one that destroyed him there that day. I can still destroy him today. Amen. People say, well, Brother Miller, why are you... Listen, amen. When you study the Bible, God begins to reveal things to you. Amen. When you say, God, open up my understanding, he'll show you the understanding of the Word of God. Yeah, amen. He said, ask for understanding. Ask for wisdom. Ask for knowledge. Amen. They all work together. If you don't have understanding, then you can't have wisdom and knowledge. Amen. And I said, Lord, I'm asking you for understanding. When I read this today, you show me. Amen. And he began to show me, amen, that Dagon, amen, is what people are worshiping today. What does Walt Disney do? Walt Disney's got the Little Mermaid. Yeah. Amen? They're worshiping Dagon. Amen? That's a god. Amen? And the Philistines, that's what they worship. Amen? They done everything. The Philistines, they done everything. If you read the Bible about the Philistines, they were wicked. Amen? And they were evil. Amen? So this world is getting the same way. Amen? But it's good to be God's house tonight. Amen. My sister Connie, you guys one tonight? You ain't got one tonight? Amen. Sister Bonnie, you guys one? Hallelujah, Jesus.
Been walking the same old road for miles and miles. If you've been hearing the same old voice of the same old lies.
Amen. Come on.
If you try to feel the same old voice inside, there's a better life. There's a better life. If you got pain.
That's right. Yes, it is. Hallelujah.
He paid a great price.
never die. Right. Amen. There'll be no need for death no more. Amen. Won't be no need for shedding of the blood. Amen. Hallelujah.
No, it's just a good time. Inside of me. He has been too good to me. And as I was laying there and I was talking to him, I said, Lord, every x-ray I've had, every blood work I've had, every test I've ever had, Every time I've ever went to any doctor, you've always been with me.
That's right.
So why shouldn't I give him some praise?
That's right. Amen.
Why shouldn't I give him some praise?
That's right.
He is better to me than I ever have deserved him to be.
Yeah,
and sometimes I have felt so unworthy. And I even tell him that even now. I said, Lord, I feel so unworthy for you to praise, for you to bless me like you do. And it's the truth. I mean, it's the truth.
Right.
Sometimes I go through many things. Our family has went through one thing after another after another. Nora, I have went through so much in my health. And then Misty, bless her heart, she was in so much pain yesterday. I said, if I could take it from you, I would. I truly would. Just like Jesus did for us. When he carried that cross up to Mount Calvary, he didn't have to do that. But he did it for us.
Yes, amen.
All the stripes he bore, he did it for us.
Right.
So if somebody can't praise him, there's something bad
right.
wrong.
Right, come on.
There's something bad wrong.
Amen.
But I want him to know tonight, I love him.
Yes, amen.
And Misty said twice, she was on the elevator, and the Lord spoke to her and said, if you'll do better, eat better, and take back your health,
right.
I'll heal you.
Right.
When she went to have her surgery, I got to tell this, but when she went to have her surgery yesterday, that doctor come in. He said, well, he had asked her about losing some weight.
Yes.
He said, I seen you lost a little bit of weight here. She said, yeah. I was way up to 390-something. I don't care if she's watching and hears me anyway.
Come on.
She said, I was up to 390-something, 396. And, well, today, yesterday, she weighed 357. So he came in, he gave her a high five. He said, that's so good. He said, I'm so proud of you. He's a really nice doctor. And even through it all, her BP had been up so bad. And they said if it got up very high, they couldn't do the surgery. They afraid she'd stroke out. Well, guess what? When she got to the hospital, and they got her on up there in the room, they took it and it was down. Then they take it again and it be up. And then they take it again and it be down. And so then when they wheel her back,
right.
For that surgery, of course she takes the woozy shot, you know, makes you kind of out of it. I don't never take it. I tell them I don't want it. Not because I'm better than nobody. I just want to know what's going on until they have to knock me out. So anyway, she took it. She said, well, Mama, when they wheeled me back there, I just didn't care, really. I said, well, that's good. But here's the amazing thing. After she come into recovery, her oxygen got down into like 80-something. I want to think 87, 88. The anesthesiologist came over there and he said, honey, I need you to take a few deep breaths for me. And I think they may have had her on some oxygen a little while. And of course, she don't remember doing none of this because she was still under the anesthetic, and plus they'd give her pain medicine where she was hurting so bad.
Yeah.
And of course, they blow you up like a big balloon, too. It's, you're full of that, you know.
Yeah.
And so, anyway.
That's the worst.
But I'm telling you, God is good.
Yes,
I mean, he's really good. And, you know, a lot of people bleed after this operation. So far, she's not. I thank him for that.
Yeah.
Her iron had been way down to 37. They said for some reason her body just can't keep iron absorbed all the time. Well, there again. They took a test and it was up a little bit. She's got a long way to go, but I'm thankful for the little things.
That's right.
Yeah.
My grandson, he had been going through some stuff that nobody knew about for many years. He never opened up and talked about it because that's just how he is. But I'm going to tell this. He went to be with his real dad because he had just lost his mama. He even stayed all night up there. I think it done him some good. But today I was standing in the kitchen after I'd done my work with my job. I went and helped her all day. And as I was standing there at the sink, he come in there and wrapped me right up in his arm. I mean, tight as he could go for it. He's a big old boy. And he was pretty stout, pretty strong, but he held on and he kept hugging me. I was hugging him back. And he said, Nanny, I ain't really got to spend a whole lot of time with you, and I'm sorry. I said, it's okay. We're all only here for a season.
It's okay.
He said, but I just want you to know, I'm really sorry that I haven't spent time with you. And I love you. I said, son, I love you too. So God is truly turning things around. My oldest son had been seeking for a job. He didn't want to go back to third shift. I don't blame him. He's done it for many years. But the Lord opened the door. Right here in Glasgow. In day shift.
Amen.
I'm thankful for that. Because he drove it over and over again, many years. I'm thankful for that. Not only thankful about that, but Mother's Day and Father's Day, he always gets these sentimental cards, you know, you just have to cry, you can't help it. And so, he come by to see Dad right there. And he had another tearjerker. And I said, that has got to be the sweetest card. But I desire y'all's prayers for my other son. He's backslidden. I don't know what's wrong with him. I don't know why he don't even come back. I try to get little, I call them nuggets, in there, here and there. But he don't want to hear it much. He's grown cold. I mean cold. And then his wife... It took many years for her to get in.
That's right.
And then when she did get in, he got out.
Right.
So now she don't really want to get back in either. And Misty has prayed, and she's warned him. There again, there ain't nothing we can do but pray.
That's all we can do.
We just have to pray. And I mean, I don't understand. I mean, I talk to my sister until I just get tired. I mean, I do. I get tired. Because I don't... She thinks some things is okay. It's not okay. And I've had to get serious with her lately. I don't like to do that. But sometimes you got to show tough love. If that's what it takes, you got to do it. But that's why I have sang this song often. Because I do have a praise inside of me.
That's right.
He has brought me a long way. And when I say a long way, I mean a long way. If anybody ever was in the very bottom, it was me. And he picked me up out of that darkness. That's why I say he reached way below the bottom for me. Because he truly did reach way down.
That's right.
And I'm so thankful. I love him. I love everybody. And I just want you to know to keep praying for us, that we'll always do what Lord
has
to do.
That's right, amen.
And I mean, you know, I just want to get closer to the Lord. And it doesn't matter what church they go to, I want to love them just the same.
Yeah.
You know, I've been going over and visiting where my daughter goes some. I'm not going to lie and say I haven't. But it doesn't mean that I'm not going to still come here. So I'm going to get that out there before anybody says anything. But anyway, I love y'all. And this church has been good to us. Me and Morris talk about it all the time. We couldn't ask for better people to love us and show us love than we have had right here. Appreciate y'all.
Oh,
seen Sister Sharon a few days ago in the hospital.
Yes.
She and I was talking, and she said, you know, I'm ready to go. I'm not afraid to die. She said, I just hate to leave my family, my kids. And I told her, I said, to Sister Sharon, that's the way of me too. I said, it's not that, you know, that I worry about luxury or whatever. I said, but when I go, I said, and I don't know when I'm going to go. I said, we don't know. I said, but when I go, that's what I'm, you know, I don't want to have to leave my family, my friends, my kids. But she made everything right, and she lived for the Lord, and she was ready to go. Though we hate to see her go, you know, she was ready to go be with Jesus. And I thank the Lord that she's no longer suffering.
Amen. Praise the Lord. Everybody will us stand. Let's give God a big hand clap of praise tonight. Amen. He deserves it. Amen. With your good reports. Amen. Hallelujah. Lord, we thank you tonight, God, for your presence. Thank you, Lord God, for your mercy and your grace. God, you're worthy to be praised tonight. Lord, we lift you up, God. We lift you up above all names tonight, Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. God, we thank you and we praise you tonight, Lord. God, we just give you praise, glory, honor, for it all, God. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Praise the Lord, praise the Lord. You know what? They clapped louder than that for Donald Trump a while ago. Amen?
Amen.
I guarantee you, they clapped as much as loud for Biden, too. Amen? We need to give God all the praise that we can give him. Amen? Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Words of it.
Tonight we're going to go to Ezekiel 3:17-21.
Bless you, Lord. Bless you, Lord.
Son of man, I had made Ezekiel thee a watchman unto the house.
Ezekiel 3:17.
Oh, no, that's fine.
You're just too fast.
That's fine. I should have waited a minute.
Amen.
Son of man, I have made thee a watchman unto the house of Israel. Therefore, hear the word at my mouth, and give them warning from me. When I say unto the wicked, thou shalt surely die, and thou givest him not warning, nor speakest to warn the wicked from his wicked way, to save his life, the same wicked man shall die in his iniquity, but his blood will be required at thine hand. Yet if thou warn the wicked, and he turn not from his wickedness, nor his wicked way, he shall die in his iniquity, but thou hast delivered thy soul. Again, when a righteous man doth turn from his righteousness, and commit iniquity, and I lay a stumbling block before him, he shall die. Because thou hast not given him warning, he shall die in his sin, and his righteousness which he hath done shall not be remembered, but his blood will be required at thine hand. Nevertheless, if thou warn the righteous man that the righteous sin not, and he doth not sin, he shall surely live, because he is warned. Also, thou hast delivered thy soul.
Amen.
Let's go back up here to the first. 17. Son of man. Sister Bonnie, who's son of man? That's Jesus. This is Jesus. So, God is telling his son, you go tell them this. I'm sure growing up that your dad told you, hey, tell your friends, don't come over here around this house pulling that mess.
That's right.
If you didn't, you got in trouble.
Right.
Well, that's the same thing going with Jesus here. If he didn't warn everybody like he did, then his dad would have had a problem with him. You know?
Right.
So, but if any man is sinning and he is not told about it, or he knows about it and is told,
right,
then, you know, there's going to be consequences for that as well.
Right.
But when I say unto the wicked, thou shalt surely die, and thou givest him not warning. Again, if you do not warn him from turning from his wicked ways, then you are at fault, and when he dies, his blood is required at your hands.
Right.
Because
come
you
could on.
Have told him, and you chose not to tell
come
him.
Come on, Michael, come on.
You know, that's like, again, when your dad told you to tell your friend, don't pull that mess. That's the same thing as telling the sinner, hey, look, that's a mess. You need to get out of that. You
that's
need to
right.
go back to where you're supposed to be. You need to get back in the book, and you need to start eating from the Word of God again. That way you get back where you're supposed to be with God. And he sets you back on the path of righteousness.
Right.
Nor speakest to warn the wicked from his wicked way to save his life, the same wicked man shall die of his in his iniquity. Okay, when it says he's going to die in his iniquity, it's his deviate. He's deviating from what is right.
Right.
He has done a gross injustice. He's sinned. He's done something.
Right.
And that's what God is saying here. Go tell him. Don't sin.
Right. Come on.
And the same man shall die in his iniquity, but his blood will I require at thine hand. Okay. Again, if you know he's doing it, and you let him continue,
right,
and you stand by idly while he still does it, and something happens to him or her, and they pass on, they're passing on to hell, and that soul and that blood is on your hands.
Right.
So at that point, you have to say, Lord, please forgive me. I should have warned them, but I did not. You know, I'm sorry for disobeying you. At that point, you know, you're going to get a whipping from the Lord. The other night, we went to eat, and I got a whipping from the Lord. There was a couple that was sitting there, and they drinking them margaritas. Ooh, I need another one. Give me another one of them margaritas. Our whole church last night was just so awesome. Well, I should have spoke up and said, look, in the good book it tells you, you can't drink from God's table and the devil's table both.
Right.
You have to choose one or the other.
Right.
I got a whooping for that.
Amen.
And getting a whooping from God isn't fun.
That's right.
You know, that's just like me telling my kids, look, hey, tell your friends don't come over here and pull that mess. They get a whooping. They don't do it, they get a whooping.
That's right.
I'm sure Bonnie got a whooping in back in the day when she didn't do it.
Right.
Or anybody else in this church would have got a whooping. You know, I know Brother Miller did. He got flogged with the switch a couple of times.
Yeah.
But you know,
so
amen.
But also, yet if thou warn the wicked, and he turn not from his wickedness, nor okay, I just did that. I'm sorry. Again, when a righteous man doth turn from his righteousness and commit iniquity, and I lay a stumbling block before him, he shall die. So, in other words, you haven't told him anything, so he's going to pass on, and he's not going to make it to the kingdom of heaven.
Right.
And he shall die because thou hast not given him warning.
Right.
He shall die in his sin,
come
in
on.
His righteousness,
come on.
Which he hath done shall not be remembered. In other words, all of his good deeds and his testimony. His testimony is destroyed.
Right.
Because he turned from what he was doing on the right path.
Right.
And he chose to go with the devil and go down through the bad path.
Right.
You know, that's what this world is coming to nowadays.
That's right.
People that are in the right path are deciding, hey, you know what? It's a little easier. Just go on and slide right over here.
Come on.
And let's go on and do what the devil wants us to
do. Right, come on.
Because it feels better.
Right.
It feels better. We can get more done that way. Well, you know what? I'm going to stay in the path of righteousness.
Right, come on.
I'm going to stay in the path of righteousness. I'm going to preach on myself here for a minute. If I say something to Sister Bonnie, which that's my wife, and it's out of sorts, then that is applying to me as well, because, you know, I'm not in a path of righteousness speaking with her or, you know, anything like that. So, got to be done the same way.
Right.
Nevertheless, if thou warn the righteous man that the righteous is sin not, and he doth not sin, and he surely live, because he is warned, and thou hast delivered thy soul.
Right, come on.
What that means is, you went to the person that was sinning and told him, look, you need to stop.
Right.
You need to come back to the good side. You know, leave the devil alone, leave the world alone, come back to God.
Right.
Come back to Jesus. That's where you need to be. You need to be in the path of righteousness. With the way the world is turning out, it's not going to be long. He's coming back. You need to be here.
Right.
So, you know, not only did you save their soul, but you saved your own.
Right.
And you saved another whipping from the Lord.
Right.
Because you have told them that that's where they need to be, and they've listened. So, but I believe that's all I got.
Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Hallelujah.
He pulled out that notebook and I said, man, he got a whole list wrote.
Amen. He done good tonight. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
If we don't want him, amen. Like Brother Michael said, we sit in a restaurant and we watch church people come in, sit and drink, and we don't say nothing to them, we get in trouble for it. Amen.
That notebook has the word written down in it. Not only do I look it up, but I write it down.
Yes.
And I also print it off. That way, if I have any problem seeing, then I got
Amen.
It.
So, how many of y'all been in a restaurant and seen church people just sit and turn them up? They just sit and talk. Well, I just went to church. And we just sit there and just let them talk. Amen. I like that, Brother Michael. You done good. Amen. I'm proud of you. Amen. Mama told me, she said, you need to get Michael preaching in. I believe he's got another one for us. Amen. So he done good tonight. Amen. Those, amen, that needs to pray tonight, this altar's open. Amen. Stand all over the house. Amen. Sister Norris sings altar call song. Amen. This altar's open. Amen. You want to talk to the Lord? Amen. You got a place here to talk to Him. Amen. Hallelujah.
He's so completely
satisfied with me.
1499 Burksville Road. May God bless you from He's Alive Community Church is our prayers.